just before going to my presentation, formally I need to say 2 or 3 minutes about the total presentation. It's my pleasure. And you see, my title of the presentation is Libraries in Digital Management, Experience Sharing of Innovators. From morning to till now, we have heard how HDC can be assumed in different aspects and why a library can be best suited for them. And I think IFLA and many international organizations, national organizations, they are thinking on it. This is not the new era, basically. You see, this is HDC 13. What I'm going to touch through this presentation. In my perception, we are playing everywhere our passive role, not active role. This is our bad luck. This is very much, we cannot work as a leader every time we are providing services for the other research purposes. But as a professional, I always believe, strongly believe, that we need to play active role. And I am, from my student life, trying to just keep myself for this quiet world. I am prepared for this quiet world because I'm not supposed to give you any passive service. I would like to do something myself. And that is the project, that is the presentation that will show you how a library project achieved HDC as a cross-cutting issue. In our, I think, IFLA concept and many other concepts, we always supposed to say library, its role of libraries is always submissive, it's always a little bit oppressed, suppressed by some other professions. Somebody thinks that we are from marginalized people, we are from marginalized profession, but I am completely differ with their opinion. That's why I told you it's an innovative project that we intervened in a very remote rural areas in Bangladesh where more than 20 people, 20 different professionals work here as an employee under my direct supervision. So it's my proud that I'm going to show you the project. Thank you very much, and I'm just entering into my presentation right now. You see? First of all, one may ask me why I have just used this sort of tablet here. It reveals something, because this presentation is not only for the local users, it is for international users. It's a picture reveals that yes, the student, the people, the children, I mean, they are the very extreme poor children. They are staying in a very remote rural areas, and they are not going to school at all. Every time they are playing, they don't know school is free for them. Why are we living, just think. They don't know school is free for them, even in this stage, I mean 2020. This is the scenario of our remote rural areas. And this picture reveals that yes, how vulnerable our rural people is. And this is the statistic basically I would like to speak. Here only two information is very important. The coastal zone, because the whole presentation is on disaster management, especially on DRR, disaster risk reduction. So we need to know the areas. There are 734 kilometers we have the coastal zone. It is based on 2019 statistics, and coastal population is 50 million. I think Munir Bhai in his presentation mentioned earlier that 60% people, they are staying in a very vulnerable zone, I mean disaster prone areas. So ignoring this sort of people, how one country can achieve their SDG? It's quite impossible. So we need to think them as a vital economic force in our country. Not only our country, everyone. We need to accommodate them with our development projects. Otherwise, we cannot run properly. Economically, we cannot claim ourselves as a solvent nation. So that is the scenario of the father of nation, because you know, this year, I don't want to mention, the whole year we could wait to celebrate, and he has given us this country, and her daughter is now in power. So this is the statistics in this tenure, rebels. And this is the study area, basically, the coastal zone in Bangladesh. 19 districts, which are very much disaster prone areas. I would like to share some recent statistics. You know our recent development. In 2010, our extreme poverty rate was 31.5%. But within 2019, dramatically it has changed. You see, it has come to 12.9%. What I would like to mention, we have a burden of overpopulation. At the same time, a series of shocking, a series of natural disasters we are facing every year. Even the last month, last December, I think you all have known about Bulbul. Before that, on the month of May last year, we are also familiar with Fani, Sidor, Ayla, all the things, I think many names, not only names, we have a very bitter experience from this sort of disasters. This is another kind of disaster, but we are facing flood, we are facing flash flood, we are facing waterlogging. Every is in the conference, people asked us very fast, is there a question that what is your magic, man? Why your economy, even the recession, why your economy is not fall down, it's not going fall down? What is the magic? Why? How can you keep your GDP in such a way that is very, very astonished to us? Why? You see, in this presentation, I think you will get the answer. It is basically the can-do attitude of the people. People can do any kinds of work. The Bengali people, our people, has no hesitation to do any sorts of work. Amazing. And prehistory of disaster, it is just for all of your information that yes, I need some water, sir. After 1971, after liberation, we have already experienced of 200 natural disasters. 200 natural disasters we have faced. And more than 2 lakhs people died and cost economic loss, total $18 billion. And you see 1.8% of the GDP loss every year. And just facing this sort of problem, this sort of people hired them. Right now they are hired. It's a very good news for us that our people, though they are literally illiterate, academically illiterate, but facing this sort of problem, they are gathering experience. So after 1991, government changed its approach. Just what will be its responses? What will be the recovery? What will be the rehabilitation and prevention, and how we can mitigate and prepare? After 1998, their plan got commented. And I think all of you are very familiar with this sort of disaster. You see Sidor, you see Ayla. I think font has been changed, but this is the picture of the Sidor. Another one is Ayla, another one is a flood, and this one is flash flood, you know, it happened in our area. In Nikli, Nithaman, who still were there, they know it very well. People cultivate their crops in the land, and they depend on it completely, but after a certain time, suddenly flood comes and devastated all of their crops. Basically, not devastated their crops, their dreams also devastated, because they have then come. They are now there, they have been shifted to Dhaka or some other areas for work purposes. They don't have any alternative. So this flash flood areas I also covered. And this is, you see, river erosion areas. This is the picture, people are waterlogged, and girls, when they would like to go to school, but they are not going over there because the school has also been devastated. And extreme poor children in coastal belt, you see, they are not going to school. Just sometimes they are sitting on a tree, sometimes they are sitting in the class or just running their academic activities. Some people who want to do this. Now come to the point. What we did, that is very general information that I have mentioned to you. Very interesting, you see. It is only for disaster risk reduction. In the project, it was 3-year project since 2013-2016, funded by Bangladesh government and Irish. I worked in concern 7 years. So I had the opportunity to work over there as a head of the consultant, as a head of the project, because it's my brainchild. I'm confidently saying it's my brainchild that working in a project, working in health, working in HIV AIDS areas, working in disaster management areas. They have 5 special segments. I several times visited a lot of areas in Bangladesh with our project people. And I have seen how BRAC, how ASHA, they all are working over there. Watching that scenario, it has kept in my mind that why not, if they have established their library over there, but people are not aware about their library, so why not we are going to establish one information center in that zone? We have to establish one library over there, and there will be no book. You see, in this library, there is no any book. Just there are some training module and some other things I am doing. You see, we worked on 7 disaster prone areas. Which areas we worked? I am just mentioning. Total beneficiary was 7,000, implemented by Concern Worldwide and our research team. So, see the next slide, purpose of this study. It was idea sharing. Sustainable change the lives of the coastal people, achieved outcomes will be shared with the relevant policymakers, and best practices will be developed. Library can change the lives of the extreme poor people. This is the message. Yes, library can. It has succeeded in its attempt. That's why we called it a role model. This project was a role model. Not to us, Ministry of Disaster has recognized it as a role model project. And its objective was basically to reduce the risk of the vulnerable people from natural disaster through an innovative approach of a library. And its overall objective was increase the coping mechanisms of the affected people, save wealth and life risks of the disasters, extricated the cause. Why community people have identified the library as a very useful and real learning center. And explain how at the end of the project, it has been increased capacities of the local NGOs, disaster management committees, because we have provided them training. So disaster management committees will also raise strength in doing them. And the community people as well. Information is power. We all know information is power. So when we just give them information, when we just disseminate them information, especially on amplifier, based on disaster risk reduction, and community radio, only by this morning said, this community radio works very well. It works like a tonic to the people. People believe it seriously. They could not believe earlier that yes, no, the signal number 10, don't bother. Signal number 9, don't bother. I will go to the sea for catching some fish because I have to survive first. But once we have created this awareness, please don't go. You cannot go. This information works as a tonic to them. And they have been shifted from them, from coastal areas to the shelter centers. And they saved their lives with their life strokes and some things. This is the practical thing that happened. Study of 7 risk upojala, high risk upojalas, I mean disaster risk prone areas. And the methodology we have applied, you see, FGD, KII, AI. AI is a very special thing for all of your information. I think a lot of library information science students are here. AI is appreciative inquiry. You know, what motivated us to do one project over there? During baseline survey, before the project, we just did one baseline survey. And on the baseline survey, we have asked for these children on that. This is basically the 7 disaster prone areas. I mean, Shariatpur, Shirazganj, Borguna. I have mentioned some areas. Their children, we asked, do you know who is the president of Bangladesh? They said no. But when I say, do you know who is the actor, I mean Nayak Don Cinema? She was Shah Rukh Khan. Believe it. They said yes, Shah Rukh Khan. We know his name. So they know because of satellite communication, because of television, they don't have the television, but the marketplace, I mean at the marketplace and the club, there are some TV, students are not going to school, their parents are going for working, and this chance they are taking, staying long time in the club, watching one by one movie. So they don't know information about our country, about any, needed information, but unnecessary information, and they attracted it very well, I mean television. This motivated us that yes, we need to bring back that students through some visual materials. It inspired us. We have to develop some visual materials, I mean video. Then we will call them, we will set up one school, we will set up one corner room as a library and collect some video, collect some documentary, collect some training modules, and collect some sort of, I think, you are giving me sleep.
Yes, time is over.
Time is over.
I think, please, I am seeking you some extra 5 minutes. And this is first for me that you have given me sleep by motivating some other people, I think. So, I think all of you are enjoying this. If so, then I will sit, otherwise not. So, you see, this develops the motivational causes. Then we have designed some sort of videos. I'm going very fast right now. Over there, we have asked this sort of question to them. And finally, you see that the question number 3, what kind of support family provides for you before, during, and after disaster? They have said, if you go through my complete full text, it has already been ready to publish in International Journal of Library and Information Science. It has been accepted. And the next issue, it will be published. But meanwhile, I have the text, what I have sent over there. You can, if you desire, I can send you this. You see, this is the 7 vulnerable zone where we have worked. Demlik 1, Demlik 2, Demlik 3. This is the area I have particularly mentioned, that yes, Kaliajuri, Dharmabasa, this is the Haur area. Another one is seasonal flood occurs in Dolapur and Kazipur. This is flood prone area. And tropical cyclone also happened in Borguna and Pakurgata. This is basically the tropical cyclone areas. This is the Demlik, you see. Demlik stands for this. I need to mention you, I need to share you the collection of these libraries. Collection was basically need-based different training modules, training equipment like light boy, first aid, rope, torch, bicycle, boat with engine, umbrella, torch light, comprehensive disaster management training materials, disaster-related posters, audiovisual materials, community radios, hand mic or sound amplifier, illustrated books, posters, banner, inspirational tailor-based videos that we made, and we involved them to the internet so they can use it very easily. So why Demlik needed, I mentioned in my early space. I will show you, I'm skipping some sort of slides. Demlik, an innovative library approach adopted in the project. I told you that yes, government and NGOs traditional approach always never bring as usual, always bring as usual result in the name of poverty alleviation. That's why new approach is needed. And I'm just going to my last slide that will reveal everything to you. Demlik, how it works, you see. Students are, people are now empowered. Their parents are now empowered. Students are empowered. Demlik deliverables. These are the deliverables. Okay, I'm just, this is the statistics that we have surveyed over there. I'm going to the last slide. Oh, for all of your information, you see that is Irish cricket team. As the project has been undertaken, intervened by Ireland government. That's why when the team has visited Bangladesh, we had that opportunity to bring them over that areas. Basically, only one area they have visited, but in cricket match with their children, we organized here in Dhaka. And I was fortunately over there as an anchor. I presented my role as an anchor. So I just inserted this slide here for the motivational purposes. And the children was very much motivated by it. You see, I am just here.
In red shirt,
yeah. Right. International media, they have also given a good coverage. And progress is increased capacity of the 2nd local NGOs and 20 disaster management committees with disaster risk reduction